A two-out, two-run home run Saturday by William Hamiter pulled Alabama ahead of Ryder and allowed the Tide to live another day in the NCAA baseball tournament's Ruston, Louisiana regional. Hamiter's seventh-inning shot was a much-needed sign of offensive pop from No. 3 seed Alabama, which won 3-1, and avoided being eliminated by the No. 4 seeded champions of the Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference. Alabama will play Sunday at 2 p.m. Central Time against the loser of Saturday evening's game between No. 1 seed Louisiana Tech, the bracket host, and No. 2 seed North Carolina State. I felt like today we didn't bring it all the way, but when Hamiter hit the home run, it put a spark in us to let's go ahead and finish this thing and go out strong, said Alabama starter Dylan Smith, who pitched a complete game. We didn't want this to be our last game. The Tide entered Saturday's elimination game having scored a total of 3 runs in its past 3 games, all losses, since an upset SEC tournament win over Tennessee. Alabama went 4-for-29 at the plate in an 8-1 loss Friday to NC State, then began 3-for-22 against Ryder, which had allowed 18 runs Friday to Louisiana Tech. It's no secret that we haven't been great offensively, coach Brad Bohannon said. I'm not sure at any point this year, but especially the last 3 or 4 weeks. I don't think we brought the right mentality offensively to the plate the first half of the game. Bohannon pulled his team together in the dugout in the middle of the fourth inning and delivered a forceful message that was shown on television. Really, I just challenged our guys, he explained. Lose today and the season is over. Show some fight. These kids have showed a lot of fight this year. I kind of felt like the first 2 or 3 innings that Ryder was more excited to play than we were. Maybe they just had more to play for, and I shared that in layman's terms to our team. A lead-off walk from centerfielder Caden Rose in the seventh inning forced Broncos starter Frank Doelling from the game, and Alabama's next 2 batters advanced Rose to third base ahead of Hamiter's homer. Happy that we were able to do enough, but we've got to get some more hits and we've got to be more efficient, Bohannon said. Rose, a freshman from Madison who entered the game with a .189 batting average, hit an RBI double in the second inning to tie Alabama with Ryder, 1-1. The No. 8 hitter in the lineup, Rose also appeared to have an RBI infield single in the fourth inning that was erased on a baserunner interference call against teammate Drew Williamson. I didn't get a good look at it, but just talking to our staff, it sounds like it was the right call, Bohannon said. That's tough on the baserunner. As soon as the ball is put in play, you want to run as hard as you can, and you have to give the defender a clear opportunity and path to the baseball. It sounds like Drew didn't do that.